Syracuse tonight, and they lost an overtime game in Ithaca to the Big Red by a total of 8 points. And Mike, going into this game, Marist has had a 6-day layoff since that last contest. How will that affect them tonight?
Well, Dean, I think at this point in the season, considering Marist has been experienced and young players, it's probably beneficial. This way, in between, the coaching staff has a chance to correct a lot of the mistakes that the team has made. And obviously, there has been some mistakes made in that game. But, you know, right now, in the beginning of the season, it's okay not to have too many games close. But that's going to change this week as they have a game Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday.
As for Boston University, well, they opened up fine this year. They win their first 3 games of the year. But then on Saturday night, they lost at Storrs, Connecticut, against those Huskies by a score of 89-76. And tonight, they go into the game against Marist with it what would seem a budding star in one of their guards.
Definitely. Dredrick Irving is a 6'3" sophomore. Now, surprisingly, he's not a big scorer last year as a freshman, but he's somebody who's benefited from a coaching change. Last year, John Schuster was the coach at BU, and he had a more disciplined, slow-down offense. He played for North Carolina and Dean Smith. This year, Mike Jarvis, the new coach, likes an open game, fast tempo, fast break. So things like that would benefit a player like Dredrick Irving, and he shows it. This year, he's averaging about 22 points a game.
As for this year's Marist team, again, they're led by the big guy, Rick Smith. He's been in double figures in each of the first 2 games. And how much, in your eyes, has he improved since last year?
Well, you can see the leadership role that he's taken over. It's funny, as we said last game, both Trafton Davis and Rick Smith are the leaders, and they're only sophomores. And Rick has grown up a lot. I think perhaps the most notable difference is that this year he's calling for the ball, and he's calling for it in key spots. Last year he got it, and he did his thing. This year he wants the ball.
Coming up next, it's Matt Virginie talking with Mike Breen about the game against the Terriers tonight. That's right after these messages on Quality Sports.
Marist College offers a quality education right here in the Hudson Valley. From disciplines such as business, nursing, and computer science to the traditional liberal arts, you'll find 24 undergraduate majors at Marist, 5 graduate programs, and more. Marist has $7 million in state-of-the-art computer equipment with plenty of terminals for student use. There are modern broadcast studios, soon to be located in the new Lowell Thomas Communication Center. But most important, Marist has an outstanding faculty dedicated to the success of its students. Marist College offers extensive financial aid, including McCann Foundation scholarships and $250,000 in scholarships for commuting students. Marist College, it's an education, a quality education, and it's right here in the Hudson Valley. For further information, call the Marist Admissions Office in Poughkeepsie, 471-3240.
You know why I come to CarQuest Auto Parts stores? This man, the CarQuest qualified counterman. He's got hundreds of thousands of parts, and I can't tell you how often he's helped me out.
Smitty here is a professional mechanic, and he insists on quality parts and fast service. So when he asks for wiper blades, I give him ANCO. You can't beat ANCO's performance or value. So when you need new refills, blades or arms, get the best. Get ANCO from CarQuest.
CarQuest, the right place to find auto parts.
Welcome back to the pregame show. Mike Breen along with Marist coach Matt Virginie. Coach, last week, a tough loss to Cornell. I guess you could say it's a learning experience, but there were some positive signs.
Well, there were a lot of positive signs, Mike. I've never seen losses easy, though. All losses are tough. But there were some positive things out of the game. One, the intensity of the players. I thought we played good defense. Cornell's an excellent outside shooting team. They were tough on their home court, and we took them into overtime. So hopefully we can bounce back tonight.
Now, what type of a game like that, especially the overtime on an away court, what does that do for a young team?
Well, it gives them a lot of experience, Mike. You know, going into the season, you always wonder, well, I wonder which game the kids will have their first overtime. I wonder which game the kids will have their first chance to win down the wire. So we got a lot out of that game. A lot of the players played in some different situations, and I think it's going to help us, you know, as we keep facing this tough non-conference schedule.
Now, Marist plays St. John's on Wednesday. Everybody knows about that. But by no means are you and your coaching staff and the players overlooking tonight's game.
No, Mike, I'm just worried about tonight. Boston University is an excellent basketball team. They're coming here with a 4-1 record. They have a couple big wins. They beat University of Massachusetts. They beat George Mason at George Mason, which was a heck of a ball game. So they're very, you know, well coached, and Mike Jarvis, and they're coming in here, you know, sporting a 4-1 record and playing good basketball with an experienced team. So our hands are going to be full tonight.
Now, I got one question on the St. John's game. Now, Louis Carnesecca is known for his sweater. Are we going to see any fashion trends from Matt Frigenic this year?
No, Mike. I'm going to stick with my button-down collar shirts, my knit ties, and sport coats, and that's about it.
Okay, Coach, good luck tonight.
Okay, Mike. Thank you.
Matt Frigenic, coach of the Red Foxes, as he prepares for tonight's game against Boston University. Now let's go back to Dean Darling.
Thank you kindly, Mike and Matt, and it's nice to have Matt again on our pregame show this year. Well, this is the third meeting between the two schools, the series originating back in 1980 when Marist was a Division II school, and the Terriers took advantage of that and beat them by 20 points. But then it was the Red Foxes gaining their revenge just last year up at Boston University, winning that game by 6 points by hitting 6 of 8 from the free throw line late in the game. So coming up next, it will be the first time Boston University has played here at the McCann Center against the hometown Red Foxes. Stay with us. More after this on Colony Sports.
When you're thinking about buying a used car, do you worry because you have no way of knowing who's been mucking around with the car? When you buy a not-so-used car from Avis, you don't have that worry. Our cars come from the Avis rental fleet. You know that you're getting a car that has received the constant care and professional service that Avis demands. Come down and see us at Avis on IBM Road, Poughkeepsie. You can be sure there's no monkey business when you buy an Avis not-so-used car.
When I signed up for a checking account here, no one mentioned the check charges to me.
Well, if you had read all the small print.
And the processing fee.
The contract clearly states.
And the labor bills, too.
You know, we got bills to pay, too.
At TEG, you don't have to worry about hidden costs. There are no service charges. You only pay for the checks.
Hey, where's the charge?
Hey, where's the customer?
I don't think there's anybody there. I really don't.
U.S. Cablevision allows you to give and receive during this holiday season. Give a toy to a needy child and receive one-half price installation on all cable services.
Give to Toys for Tots, Saturday, December 14th from 10 to 5 at the South Hills Mall. Toys can also be delivered to the James Way Mall in Monroe or call U.S. Cablevision for more information.
This toy and others will help make a child's Christmas a happy one. Please give to Toys for Tots.
Good evening once again from the McCann Center. Nice to have your company tonight. I'm Dean Darling along with Mike Green as we bring you another Marist College basketball game. Tonight, it's the Terriers of Boston University. They had a tough one up there in Connecticut the other night, Mike, losing by 13 points, 89-76. But yet, they still get three guys in a double-figure scoring column.
Well, according to some people from Boston University, they shot about 23% of the first half, dug themselves a deep hole, and were down by 25 at one point, but they came back strong in the second half, but just not enough.
All right, the starting lineup now announced by Rich Stevens, our public address announcer, at guard number 31, Dedrick Irving, sophomore 6'3", 166 from the Bronx, New York. The other guard, 32, Jeff Timberlake, freshman 5'11", 196 from Quincy, Massachusetts. Starting at center, first time in his career, is number 22, Isaac Hatzi, sophomore 6'7", 240 from Cocoa Beach, Florida. The other forward and leading scorer against Marist last year was 17 points, number 42, Paul Hendricks, senior 6'5", 200 from St. Thomas, Virgin Islands. And the other starting forward tonight will be number 15, and that is Dwayne Vincent, senior 6'2", 191 from Rockville Center, New York. The starting lineup now for the Marist College Red Foxes. Starting at the guard, number 14, Carlton Wade. He's a freshman, 5'11", 160 from Clairton, Pennsylvania. The other guard will be number 12, Grafton Davis, sophomore, 6-footer, 165 from the Bronx, New York. Starting at center will be the big guy, 7'3", sophomore, 240 from Eindhoven, Holland, Rick Smith. At a forward, number 10, Alain Forcier, sophomore, 6'6", 200 from Nice, France. starting five for Matt Prajanic is number 43, Miroslav Pokorski, freshman 6'11", 210, from Novi Sad, Yugoslavia. The Marist team coached by Matt Prajanic. As you see, Matt, on your screen, he comes in with a record of, at Marist, of 18-13 in his second year, overall record of 91-84, 52% winning percentage. You know, our officials tonight will be Joe Vigna, along with Al Murray, as they have been assigned to this Boston University and Marist College Red Fox game.
You know, I think we're going to see some real pressure man-to-man defense from BU. Mike Jarvis likes that style. On the offensive end, as we said in the pregame, he's going to like to really run the ball, push it up court. That is why Dredrick Irving has really performed so well this year. You know, it's a real complete different style of play for these players from one year to the next with the coaching change.
All right, it'll be Rick Fitz to jump for Marist. He'll go against Isaac Kadzi. And to toss up the center jump is Al Murray, and we're underway with Marist in a home white uniform. They have won five in a row at home. That's carried over from last year, and Wade is off the mark in his first attempt. Here's Wade going inside. Smith. And Marist takes a quick lead with 14 ticks off the clock, 2-0. Good pass that time as it was Smith coming in back door.
Well, Carlton Wade saw as soon as they got possession of the ball that BU was not in their defensive situation. They looked a little confused, looking for a man to pick up, and Wade brought it right to the hoop. Marist kept it alive. Wade was able to again bring it to the hoop, and that time he dished off. So a nice idea of taking advantage of the fact that BU wasn't ready on defense.
And the foul charged to number 22, Isaac Kadzi. And it will be Smith at the line. As tonight's game is being brought to you in part by Pete's Mobile Car Wash on Route 9 Poughkeepsie, home of the 100% brushless car wash and good quality mobile gas and self-service competitive prices. Pete's Mobile has many services to offer, including undercarriage washing, steam cleaning engines, and vacuuming facilities. Pete's Mobile Car Wash, service that impresses.
As you can see, the delay is instead of your usual confetti that you can just whip off the court, they throw the puzzle pieces, which requires a bit more maintenance, and the cheerleader's taking care of that right now.
Smith at the line this year, Mike, is 3 of 3. Last year at the free throw line, he shot a woeful 58%. Maybe that's something good to see.
Well, that's something that has to improve when you're a big man like that, and Marist, of course, is going to be going through so much down low. He's going to pick up a lot of fouls, and a lot of his points are going to come from the free throw line. But according to the coaching staff, that is something he worked very hard in over the summer. He's continuing that work. And if he can get consistent from the foul line, maybe shoot 65 to 70%, that's going to be a lot of extra points for him.
Matt Prajanic was out there offering the officials some help in picking up the tissue paper, but they told him to go back to the pine. And at the line is Smith, and he converts the three-point play. Smith's leading score on the Marist team coming into the game with a 16.5 average, and Marist will press right off the start. That is Timberlake double team. Irving, and he finds Hendricks. He's fouled by Pekarski. They broke the press that time.
Definitely. It's a 2-2-1 zone press, and they look to trap, and they did a nice job making the trap and the double team at half court. But a good pass inside, and that's the key. If you can break that trap at half court, you can score on it because you usually have a 2-on-1 or even a 3-on-1 fast break. So Pekarski and Smith both have to be careful in case that trap is broken.
Hendricks at the line this year shooting 75%, 9 of 12. Last year he shot but 71%. And we've had an exchange of three-point plays. Full court pressure by the Terriers, and we knew they'd be doing that for Marist coming into the game.
This freshman Timberlake is an excellent defensive player. He really does not let you even breathe for a minute. A lot of pressure, and he's going to give Carlton Wade and Grafton Davis some trouble tonight.
Carlton Wade looking in for Smith, bullying his way. Good rebound torn down there by Dwayne Vincent, one of the tri-captains, the other tri-captain, Hendricks. Nobody seems to want to control the ball, and we have a turnover.
Good call that time by the official. And Paul Hendricks is the type of player. He's a senior, big 6'5" fella. He does everything. He shoots well from the outside. He hits the boards well. And as you see, he dives for loose balls. Really an all-around type of player.
Carlton Wade coming off a super performance the other night against Cornell. He was 7 of 14 from outside, 5 of 6 at the charity stripe. For 19 points, he and Shamley both with game-high 19-point figures.
On this man-to-man pressure defense, Boston University really overplaying. They're forcing them to go backdoor and other things.
Blitzel inside, and Smith being a bit too aggressive, according to Joe Vigna. He's called for the play.
Well, that again, that's because of the defense. Rick Smith is being denied the ball very heavily. They're doing a good job, and Smith's getting a little frustrated. What Marist has to do on the offensive end is just simply set a lot of screens and make sure they're constantly moving without the ball.
Last year against the Terriers, Smith was held in check with just 6 points, 3-7 from the field, 0-1 from the line. Minute and a half going by. We're knotted at three. Taking the open popper, it's Dwayne Vincent. Good rebound by Pekarski, who leads the team in that category, pulling down 8.5 a game. Here's the guy that you want with the ball commanding your offense. That's Drafton Davis. Carlton Wade. Good positioning on the board by Hendricks, and here's BU running it up. Boston University, coached by Mike Jarvis in his first year at BU. Players really respect him. As BU comes in with a record of 3-1 on the road, they are 1-1. 3-3 the score. 17 minutes, 50 seconds remaining, opening half. Dwayne Vincent. Vincent at 18 the other night against the Huskies, and he looks like he's starting up again.
Normally a sixth man tonight, he's starting. Mike Jarvis wanted to shake things up a little bit after the loss to UConn, but he's like Mr. Everything to the team.
BU takes the 5-3 lead, more pushing and shoving inside, and this time Smith was the man that was being held. Okay. So Al Murray will make that call.
Smith and Kotsky both are really a lot of pushing. Next time down court, take a look at Kotsky really overplaying, and Rick gets frustrated at first before he starts to realize the things he has to do, and he just has to make sure he doesn't foul him back and set screens.
You know, interesting move, Jarvis going tonight with Kotsky, who's never started in his career and rarely sees playing time, and he's in there really to bully Smith's around, the starting center. Ivy is not starting here tonight, as it is Forstier called for too many steps.
And that's something that we saw him pick up quite a bit last year. He's worked on that, but that time a little over-anxious. That's the type of turnover you see from this kind of pressure defense. Boston University really overplaying the man, denying the ball, and Marist, again, has to be a little bit more patient.
Irving, he's the real shooter, coming off a game-high 28 points against Connecticut. This is the mark, and it's tapped out of bounds.
Now, the reason Marist got that rebound, Carlton Wade had Hendricks boxed out perfectly. Now, he couldn't get the rebound, but neither could Hendricks.
Full court pressure again by the Terriers. Tonight's game being brought to you by Kine Construction Company, located at Red Oaks Mills Road in Poughkeepsie. It pays to call an expert for all your home improvement needs. Terriers leading the Foxes 5-3, 3 minutes going by, first 20 minutes. Dean Darling and Mike Breed on Colony Sports. Davis, Forstier, they wheel it around the horn. That's where they want it, Smith and the popper.
That's the shot they want, Dean. You know, it just didn't fall that time, but Marist did a good job being patient. What Boston University is doing is they're double-teaming Smith. As soon as he gets the ball, Rick should just dish it out quickly if he has two men on him.
Hendricks had a game-high 10 rebounds against Marist last year up at BU. Irving negotiating the baseline. Late whistle by Joe Vigna.
I believe he called it in the act. So it wouldn't be two shots. Pekarski that time did a nice job coming over and closing off the baseline. But a very smart pass by Dredrick Irving to get the man inside.
That's Drafton Davis getting the foul. Third team on Marist. Boston University with two. And Kotsky, the native of Cocoa Beach, Florida, averaging under 2 points a game, was a walk-on this year. Played for Canada in the Maccabee Games this past summer.
This is his first free throw of the season, Dean. It looks it.
And the student section is up and applauding. Good crowd again. You want to venture a guess?
No, I think I was a couple of hundred off the other night. I'll stay away from those predictions.
I'll go with 2,800 today. You could say he isn't adept at the foul line.
Free throw shooting is going to be very important in this game. Because of the aggressive defense, there'll be a lot more fouls, more trips to the line. And I think the team that really can convert their free throws is going to be in good shape.
Mike Jarvis did not like what he saw, and coming in now will be Mike Ivy. Check that, Tom Ivy in for Isaac Kotsky.
There's the second traveling violation against Marist. Again, you can credit that to the defense. Right now, BU is overplaying so much that when a Marist player gets the ball, it's kind of like you're elated. You finally got the ball, you got three, and you get a little over-anxious, thus the walking violation.
Third turnover for the Red Foxes, as they come in averaging a very high 23 a game. Timberlake. Dedrick Irving going inside. playground move. Hendricks has it. Wisely pulls it back out. Marist in that zone defense up on the top is Forcier. You can see him jumping out there on Timberlake. They're leaving that corner jumper open, and there it is. Dwayne Vincent hitting it.
Well, Matt Prochanek wants a little more height up on top of the zone.
Bad pass inbound. And now it is picked off by the Terriers. Vincent from the same spot.
Marist could use a timeout right now, and that's exactly what Matt Prochanek is going to do.
And BU takes a quick 6-point lead, 9-3, with 4.5 minutes going by into the first half. As you see, Boston University over Marist. We'll be back after this.
When we close this box, we've done our best. When you open this box, you enjoy the best. Hot, fresh pizza delivered to you in 30 minutes or less.
The feeling of uncompromising excellence.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile can make it yours.
Comfort blended with advanced engineering.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile makes it affordable.
Performance, grace, and style. America's most popular cars are Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile.
All new high technology front wheel drive quality cars. Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile gives you the best deal.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile, 200 Church Street, Poughkeepsie.
Being brought to you in part by CarQuest Auto Parts. Get your car in great shape at these CarQuest stores and Highland Auto Parts at Poughkeepsie 9G Auto Parts and Poughkeepsie Auto Parts. And at Hopewell Junction, it's Hopewell Auto Parts. Also in Fishkill, Route 52 Auto Parts. The right products at the right prices. That's why America is shaping up at CarQuest.
I'm sure Matt Prochanek right now is telling the team to take it easy on offense. 45 seconds is a lot of time. They have to be more patient. And, of course, look to get the ball inside. Marist does not want to be shooting 18, 20, 22-footers at all. They want to take advantage of their height advantage. So Prochanek probably said, listen, fellas, take it easy. Set the screens. Get the ball inside. Use up 35, 40 seconds of that 45-second clock.
Fourth turnover on Marist on that last inbound play that went awry. Davis pushing off a bit on Timberlake, going for the inbound pass, and they had words. Bad pass by Davis. Chamblee checking in on the next court. Timberlake rushing to the forecourt. Dedrick Irving averaging 22 a game this year. Three times he's been over the 20-point mark. Tom Ivey, who did not start at center today, but now into the game. BU really whips it around the horn. Here's Timberlake. Getting up high, it's Pekarski using the elbows. Marist going left to right, wearing those home white uniforms. Last year here at home, they were 9-5. BU on the road last year was 6-8. Carlton Wade.
Now, that's not the shot that Matt Prochanek wants to have taken. You need a few of them just to keep the defense honest. But again, Marist really not looking to get the ball inside more, and that's something they have to do if they want to win this ball game.
9-5, Boston University leading the Red Foxes. Nice block by Pekarski on the shot by Hendricks. Ivy has it put back in his face by Smith.
And it bounced off Ivy himself, so Marist will get possession. Marist got a break that time because Boston University found that diagonal pass open. But there's where the height comes into play. You might get beat on defense, but you make up for it in the height and able to block two shots.
Chamblee has checked in for Forcier. And you can see Marist having trouble getting the ball inbounds, and Chamblee did not call the timeout in time.
That's right. Now, the rule on that is if the referee is up to number four on the five count, he can't give the timeout. If it's on one, two, or three, he can give it. But once he's to the count of four, he cannot give the timeout.
And here is Irving singling the twine for two. And it is now 11-5 game. Boston University out in front by six. Vincent leading the team in scoring with three field goals for 6 points. Wade, again, a bit too far out on the shot.
I think Matt Pajanic's going to make a change to get somebody who can get it inside.
Good steal by Wade. He has Shamley on his left. Good pass. And we have a block down on the far end. Now both teams will go to the bench. Beckwith coming in for Marist. Timberlake coming out for Boston University. There you see Mark Jarvis on your screen.
A lot of substitutions going to be going on tonight. A very aggressive game thus far, especially with the Boston University defense. But Marist, again, they have to remain patient. Right now, really, you know, we're saying that the ball is not being getting inside, but the thing is that the men are not moving without the ball. They're not getting open.
DaCosta has checked into the guard spot, number 10 for Timberlake. As we mentioned, Beckwith has been put into the game for Wade. Say much about that, Mike.
That's for sure. A beautiful pass that time. That's where Beckwith is very good. He's an excellent penetrator. He drew two defensive men to him. Thus, Pekarski was open.
11-7. Boston University leading by four. Muscle move by Ivy, and he's hit on the play.
You know, I think Marist right now on defense is relying too much on the block shot. They're going off their feet a little quick. They're trying to go for the steals rather than stay back. So you can go for the block shot, but don't try and just make the block shot up for your defensive deficiency.
At the line will be Tom Ivy.
just has to learn to curb that a little bit, otherwise he's going to just start. Finishes half ball.
And since BU leads, they don't have to come out and play defense. Now Marist starts the move under 10 seconds. Wade going away. Tough shot. In and out. Forcier. Bougarel was thrown under the basket, and they have the push with one tick left on the clock.
I have a feeling that if that call was not made, Matt Krajanek would have either been hit with a technical or charged with attempted murder, one or the other. Nice job that time in keeping it alive by Forcier and Chandler. And then, of course, they got lucky on the foul. Not a smart foul at all by Graybill. But a real nice job by Forcier and Chandler to keep that alive and allow for another shot.
Rudy Krausovic coming in as Krajanek wants to get Chandler out so he doesn't pick up a personal foul. And Rudy Bougarel will shoot. He is one of three at the line. Now one of four, and that will do it here at halftime. So after the first 20 minutes, it'll seesaw affair that saw both teams take the lead and then relinquish and then take the lead. It is the Terriers of Boston University 36 and the Red Foxes of Marist 35. We'll be back with the halftime statistics after this.
Tastes great, and the top draft choice is Genesee.
Come down to your friendly tavern and enjoy Genesee on draft.
Genesee, the great outdoors in a glass.
The front of the car is lower, but the engine is bigger. The height is reduced, but there is more headroom. The suspension is inspired by race cars, but the ride is smooth and comfortable. The new Accord from Honda. The future is full of contradictions.
Friendly Honda, Route 44, Poughkeepsie. Availability has never been better.
Since ancient times, people have journeyed to hot springs for their rejuvenating water. Now, Pools by Kind offers you the convenience of a spa in your own backyard or den. Air jets whirl cleansing waters that ease aches, massage muscles, and stimulate circulation. The whole family will enjoy a spa from Kind.
For all pools and spas, we offer Tarm Pure, a chemical-free water purification system.
Call now 462-2669 for more information or visit the Kind showroom.
The snappy service pull into Pete's. Cars look sharp, fast at Pete's. Pete's Mobile Car Wash, the car wash with pride. First class, all cloth, completely brushless. The best gas prices on Route 9 and the nicest finish in Dutchess County. Don't let old man winter rust out your car. Keep it clean at Pete's. Conveniently located on Route 9, we accept all major credit cards. Pete's Mobile Car Wash, the car wash with pride.
I'm ready. Halftime here at the McCann Center. Dean Darling along with Mike Green, and we'll quickly now take a look at the halftime statistics. First of all, the Terriers of Boston University. And tonight, Mike, they've been faced by Dwayne Vincent, who's got 15 points for the night, 6 of 11 from the field, 3 of 4 from the line.
Well, Dwayne Vincent is the guy that we talked about earlier that usually a sixth man but started tonight. He's a fine player. That one spot on the corner jumper from the baseline, he seems to like that. He's missed his last couple, but he's the type of guy that can do it every night.
There's the rest of scoring. Gabriel with 7, Ivy with 5, Irving 4, Hendricks 3, and Timberlake and DaCosta each with 2. Now for Marist, tonight they're being paced equally by Rick Smith and Carlton Wade, both with 9, Davis with 5, Forcier with 4, Chamblee 3, Beckwith and Pokarski with 2, and Bougarel with 1.
Dean, Marist had a better percentage from the floor than they did from the free throw line. They shot 50% from the floor, but only 47% from the free throw line. That's absolutely pitiful. That's got to improve. If they want to win tonight, they've got to hit the free throws.
It is 36 for Boston University, 35 for Marist. We'll be back with the start of the second half right after this.
the lowest possible price on oil and get the convenience of automatic delivery. Colburn Oil will guarantee that you will not run out of oil. At Colburn Oil, we dispatch our trucks by radio, and for 30 years, we've been the service leaders in the Hudson Valley. Now we're the pioneers in delivering cash discounted oil to you on an automatic schedule. You don't have to remember to check your gauge. We will deliver automatically. So stop worrying and save money. Call Colburn Oil at 876-6363. Duchess AMC Jeep Renault. Catch the Jeep mystique at Duchess AMC Jeep Renault. Catch your Jeep at Duchess AMC Jeep Renault, 200 Church Street, Poughkeepsie.
When I first sipped Jody Cream Ale, I was surprised at how smooth it was and how easy it went down. It's very light and very refreshing.
Try something different. Try Genesee Cream Ale.
Jenny Cream tastes very refreshing. It's very smooth. It's very creamy. There's no aftertaste. And it's truly unique.
Jenny Cream. So different, it's America's best-selling ale.
It's like no beer and no ale I've ever tasted before.
Walking out onto the court for the Red Foxes and starting here in the second half, it's Forstier, and then in the backcourt, it's Wade along with Davis, and joining Forstier on the front line, it's Smits along with Pekarski. Totsie starting on the front line for Boston University along with Vincent and Hendricks. The backcourt, it's Timberlake and Dedrick Irving. Nice to have you along here in the second half. Colony Sports bringing you Marist against Boston University. Smits couldn't hold on. Smits had a tough game up at Cornell the other night, turning the ball over 9 times.
Well, Marist had 11 turnovers here in the first half. Most of them, I would say 6 or 7 of them, came in the first 5 or 6 minutes. So they slowed things down again, but that's not the way to start the second half.
Timberlake with a rainmaker. Totsie, who started tonight's game, couldn't control, and it will be Marist ball. Marist moving from right to left in the second half. Full court pressure now used by the Terriers. Forstier being played by Vincent, and that's the man to get the ball to, Captain Davis.
Miro Pekarski, only 2 shots he took in the first half, one of them a dunk. They've got to get him the ball more. He's got to get more in the flow of the offense.
Pekarski sitting out last year, his freshman season, with that foot injury as Wade misses. Irving spotting Hendricks. Rejection by Forstier.
He did a nice job. He went for the rebound down the other end and did a nice job going all the way from baseline to baseline to recover. Good hustle. Drafton Davis, meanwhile, was back there to protect just in case.
36-35, Boston University leading the Red Foxes.
Matt Pajanic sticking with that 3-2 zone. That seemed to work very well in the second part of the first half.
Marist coming off the 17-12 year. Year prior to that, they were 14-15. Going to the hoop, Vincent. Tried a couple taps, wouldn't go. And Pekarski secures the glass.
Now there's a nice, smart play by Pekarski. He holds on to the ball. Doesn't try and throw it out quick and get a quick turnover. He did a nice job holding on and wait for a guard to come and take it.
Totsie exchanging elbows down low with Smith. Forstier, 15-footer.
You know, Dean, he's such a streaky player. If he does something well, like block a shot, it gives him confidence. He comes down the other end ready. He's the type of guy that needs his confidence, and then he goes on a nice streak.
Should get the ball more into his hands. 3 for 4 from the field tonight. Forstier with a total of 6 points. Smith popping out on the zone. Timberlake. And there's Irving. So Irving hits it from a decent long-range position. And Irving now on the night, hitting 2 of 4 shots. The steal there by Boston. Irving trying again, and Pekarski again will sweep up the board. Here's Wade now for the Red Foxes. Davis, herky-jerky. There's where they got to go with it. Smits in traffic. Both officials look at each other saying, I wonder who's going to make the call.
Well, that's the type of thing. They look at each other and make sure who has, you know, who's definitely sure, so they don't go calling one way or the other. That time, Rick Smits did not square himself. It was one of those side halfway shots, and he can't do that. If he's not able to square, he's got to throw it back out and forget about shooting it. You You don't need off-balance shots like that.
First thing they teach you in those summer basketball camps, square your shoulders. Catch the ball, square the shoulders. That man squared his shoulders, and then he caught the ball, and then he fired up and off the glass. And that is Dedrick Irving. Again, another steal, and the crowd now starts to murmur a few things, but it's Davis stealing back for Marist.
Smart play, bringing it back out, drafted so there was nothing available, and waited for the big men to come down. That's experience. He's a sophomore, but he's a very smart sophomore.
Carlton Wade, played by Irving, going inside, good move. And guess who comes out of the pack? Bukarski, trying to get it out, and it was Hendricks ripping it off. Dwayne Vincent.
Now, both teams starting to get a little ahead of themselves right now. They know they're in a tight ball game. They're losing a lot of pressure. And plenty of time. They've got a whole half. They both have to settle down right now. That time, Bukarski on that turnover, he just got the ball in a position where he couldn't do anything with it. He tried to get it out to Rick, and Rick wasn't able to handle it.
Carlton Wade teaming in a backcourt with Jaston Davis. Gorsier with it. Smith saying, hey, give me the ball. I think I can beat my man. Bukarski. Davis. No place to go as he ran right into the body of Hendricks and steps out of bounds.
Smart defense that time by Hendricks, and it was especially nice when Davis went in. Timberlake laid off Davis and picked up Bukarski, and that way Davis had nowhere to throw the ball.
Marist with 15 turnovers already in the game. Remember, they commit averaging 23 on the season.
Now Marist has switched to a man-to-man for the first time.
Irving no good, and Smith's uncontested.
Brad Krajanek trying to change things up a little bit. Show some differences at BU.
Jaston Davis on the near hash mark. Can't give that man that shot, but he missed it this time. Gorsier. Irving forgot the ball. And now Boston University wants to take a timeout with 15:41 remaining in the second half. It's Boston University 40, Marist 37. We'll be back after these messages on College Sports.
So, this is Park Discount. I hope they have everything I need. Wow, what a selection. Let's see, I'll need some of these, and hey, at these prices, I can get more for the same money. Oh yeah, imports. The guys will love these. This week's specials. Park Discount Beverage. About time I got what I was paying for.
Park Discount Beverage, Route 9, Hyde Park.
When we close this box, we've done our best. So, you enjoy the best. Hot, fresh pizza delivered to you in 30 minutes or less.
Joe, do you have 85 glasses that I could borrow? Uncle Harry, hi, how are the kids? Uncle Harry, I need 27 chairs. Hi, is this the restaurant supply? I need the price on 8 shaking dishes.
Hello, rental center. I need to pick up some items for a large party I'm having on Saturday.
Take it easy and save money. Rent for parties and banquets at the rental center.
Welcome back to the Can Center. Some of the fans here tonight, and they all love to be in front of that camera. Tonight's game being brought to you in part by Dutch's AMC Jeep Renault, 200 Church Street in Poughkeepsie. We're the best deal dealer, the one to watch. Telephone 471-1020. Well, Mike, we've got this game here tonight, Boston University. And then Marist takes the road to Alumni Gym on Wednesday against St. John's, and things get even tougher after that, if you can imagine that. They'll have a couple games in a couple days in a row. They'll be hosting the Pepsi Poughkeepsie Classic.
It's going to be interesting to see how they bounce back from playing Wednesday against a nationally ranked team like St. John's, and then coming into a tournament where the names are not as big. Now, no matter what happens on Wednesday, after you play a St. John's, you have to be careful of a letdown. So Matt Krajanek mentally has to have his team prepared to play the Coppin State and the teams like that.
They will open against Coppin State Saturday night here at the McCann Center.
That's a set play. Mike Jarvis did a nice job setting it up that time, and you can't let him score on the inbound.
And he scored.
A little Pele action here at the McCann Center.
Hendricks kicking it off the support post, and Marist will get it on the inbound. Vincent scoring that last field goal, and he leads all scorers with a total of 15 points. 42-37, Boston University leading. Carlton Wade.
Now, Wade has been on and off. It seems when he's from 15 to 18 feet, he's going to hit it. It's when he's out 20 to 22 that he has problems, and he has to realize that he's got some limitations in terms of his range and not take those long jumpers.
There's Irving, and Marist better hope he doesn't get hot in the second half. The sophomore from the Bronx, averaging 22 a game coming in. We go the other way. Wade is called on the charge.
It's time to get Carlton. Gets a little bit over anxious sometimes. You can't do that, especially when you got some fine defensive players. And, good defensive effort that time. Wade's got to bring it back out. Now, that's the difference between a Carlton Wade and a Drafton Davis. We said a couple of possessions ago, Drafton saw there was nothing there and pulled it out. Carlton tries to go in for a score, but instead gets picked up for charge.
The Terriers by five. And trying to catch a bigger lead right here in an errant pass. And now Boston University turns it over for the 10th time tonight. They come in averaging 16 miscues a game. Matt Virginic applauding his team for his defensive pressure. Now they've got to do it on the offensive end. Chamley fighting for position down low. Beckwith is eyeing him.
Yeah, it's got to get the ball to Rick Smith. There's no way that Marist has to look for him every time down and set screens for him.
Tough shot by Chamley going away from the basket, and Timberlake comes out of the pack. Three on three, and going strong is Hendricks. Follow Vincent. Two points there, scored on the goaltender.
He didn't hit the ball, obviously, but he hit the net while the ball was still up in the cylinder. You cannot touch the backboard, the net, or the rim while the ball is still up in the cylinder. That's what happened on the goaltender. You don't have to touch the ball.
Basket is credited to Hendricks. He now has 5 points on the night.
Dean, this is a big possession. They are right now down by seven. They need a basket here, and they've got to go to the big man.
And Smits is the big man that Mike's talking about. He's pushed from behind by Tom Ivey.
So half the time when a guy like Rick gets the ball, at least he's going to pick up a foul. And, we've seen that the Boston University players are physical. They do tend to pick up fouls early. So go inside. Pick up those fouls. Let Smits do it. Let Pekarski do it. Don't take those jumpers from outside.
Smits looking to break out the pack. Wade. And we have a whistle as Wade, on his release of the ball on the errant pass, knocks over Timberlake.
Timberlake stood there and took the charge. He thought Wade wasn't going to dish off. And did a nice job, picked it up.
Wade picks up his second personal foul.
And a smart timeout now by Matt Virginic. He's got to regroup, and plenty of time left, but they're lagging behind a little bit now.
Boston University, their largest lead of the night at 7. They lead 46-39. We have 14 minutes, 5 seconds remaining here in the second half. We'll be back after this.
You know why I come to Carquest Auto Parts Store? This man, the Carquest qualified counterman. He's got hundreds of thousands of parts, and I can't tell you how often he's helped me out.
You know the one thing that most people overlook about their cars is the belts. Like the man from Gates says, after 4 years, they can go anytime. So if your car is 4 years old, replace the belt. With Gates quality at Carquest.
Carquest, the right place to buy auto parts.
If you want the taste of a full-bodied import on draft, try Genesee 12-4 Sale. It tastes imported, but it's America's own. Genesee 12-4 Sale.
When you think of Avis, you think of top-notch car rentals. But Avis is tops and trucks, too. No matter what your need to move your household possessions, or if you're a businessman with deliveries to get out, Avis has the truck for you. Vans, 12-footers, 18-footers, refrigerated units, even tractor trailers. Remember, Avis has the right truck for you.
Tonight's game being brought to you in part by TEG, Federal Credit Union. Two locations here in Poughkeepsie and Fishkill. Students of Marist, Dutchess Community College, The Culinary Institute are all eligible to join TEG Federal Credit Union, serving you better by knowing you better.
You know, perhaps the most important thing for Marist to realize right now is that there's 14 minutes left in this game. 7 points is nothing in 14 minutes, especially when you have a shot clock. That's the nice thing. You can fall behind by 8 or 9 points. And, you know, last year a team would hold it out, you know, pass the ball around and just eat off time off the clock. This year, if you're down 7 or 8, you have plenty of opportunities to get back in the game. So by no means should they panic now because they have so much time left.
Boston University controlling the ball and a 7-point lead. Vincent in the backcourt with Timberlake. Then on the front line, they go with Coxie and Hendricks, and we have a foul away from the play of the ball and a hold now being called.
Drafton Davis trying to guard Dwayne Vincent. Now, Vincent is a lot taller than Drafton. He stands at 6'2", and right now the guards are posting up the smaller Marist guards.
Nobody really got a good grip on the basketball as Davis picks up his third personal foul on that last play.
Beckwith, instead of getting for the rebound, wanted to let it go out of bounds, but it glanced off his leg.
Wade going for the steal. In traffic is Hendricks traveling. 11th time tonight, BU has turned the ball over. And now coming into the game, Peter Gabriel, who in the first half had a very good first half, coming off the bench for 7 points, 2 for 2 from the field, 3 of 4 from the line.
Is Peter Gabriel a singer? Isn't he in Genesis?
That a play, Mike. You're learning. 6.5 minutes going by. Second half. Crowd starting to get into it as the Red Fox trail by 7. Holding underneath, the call made by Joe Vigna.
Again, it's impossible right now for these Boston University players to guard Rick Smith one-on-one. What they're doing, as you see the coaches both getting into their coaching act, a lot of talking to the officials, a lot of screaming at their own players. Two fine coaches, Mike Jarvis in his first year in Division I. Of course, he coached Patrick Ewing in high school. Not for Janik Lowe, we know what he can do.
Beckwith short on the jumper, follows nicely. It counts, and he fouls. You know, you and I commented in the Suffolk game that's what we like about the young guy. He might not be shooting well from the field, but he's always there to follow up the shot.
He's a very strong rebounder for a guard. Now, in high school, he played a guard even at 6'4". He averaged like 7-8 rebounds a game. He did a nice job on the boards. He's not afraid to mix it up with the big fellas, and he does follow a shot. He better follow his shot. You've got to credit him. He's not afraid to go inside with the big boys.
One of the quicker players of the team runs the 100 meters, I should say, in 10.8 seconds, and he hits that one, and that's a big three-point swing. 46-42, Marist trailing by 4. 7 minutes gone by, second half. Boston University effectively breaking the press.
And Marist, though, gets back in a hurry. Nice recovery there. The three guards have the offense now. They're in a man-to-man pressure defense.
DaCosta, Gabriel, and you can't give Gabriel all that room under the glass.
Marist is not looking to box out right now on the defensive end. Rick Smith, even though he's 7'3", he still has to box people out.
Davis barking signals like a quarterback would his football team. Smith.
You know, I don't understand why they don't do that. I mean, it's obviously you can't get him the ball every time, but at least look for it.
Davis is scored personal. Look behind you, Mike. I think they're going to start throwing things.
Well, Drafton trying to pick up the charge. That was close, to be honest. I didn't have a good angle. We were blocked by the Boston University coaching staff. But obviously, Matt Pajanic didn't like the call.
Alain Forestier rushing to the scores table. I believe Davis will be taken out because he's got 4 personals. And we have 12.5 minutes remaining. Here's the step by Beckwith. Ahead for Wade. Yes! Boston University wants to take a timeout as Al Murray signals in front of the bench. And a foul was on the Terriers. And when we come back, Carlton Wade will try and complete the 3-point play. 48 Boston University, 46 Marist. We're back after this.
The feeling of uncompromising excellence.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile can make it yours.
Comfort blended with advanced engineering.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile makes it affordable.
Performance, grace, and style. America's most popular cars are Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile.
All new high-technology front-wheel drive quality cars, Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile gives you the best deal.
Duchess Cadillac Oldsmobile, 200 Church Street, Poughkeepsie.
Draft beer tastes great, and the top draft choice is Genesee.
Come down to your friendly tavern and enjoy Genesee on draft.
Genesee, the great outdoors in a glass.
Hi, I'm Brian Cleary, athletic director at Marist College. I'm very excited to be part of the athletic programs at Marist. I want each of you to join the Marist College Red Fox Club, one of the finest athletic booster organizations in the country. Don't miss out on season tickets, preferred parking, and all the other benefits the club has to offer. For additional information, call me at 471-3240. That's 471-3240.
The Marist Huddle as tonight's game is being brought to you by Colburn Oil, 108 South Broadway, Red Hook, where you get 24-hour service and a cash discount for oil. Colburn Oil. When it's cold and you need heat, try Colburn Oil for the price to beat.
On that last basket by Carlton Wade, Tim Beckwith did two nice things. The first thing, obviously, was the excellent defensive pressure that he put on DaCosta, forcing the turnover. Then, once he got the ball and started down court, it was a two-on-two fast break, okay? Now, as Beckwith came in, both defensive men converged on him, and once they committed himself, that's when he dished off. He dished off at the precise time that he had to. Now, that's the toughest thing about a fast break, is that you have to know when's the proper time to dish off when the defensive man commits himself. That time, Beckwith waited for the right moment, and just a beautiful, beautiful feed.
Tonight's attendance, 2,909 fans supporting the Marist College basketball program.
Now here we go, Dean, with the all-important free throw. If Marist can hit their free throws, they'll stay right in here. It's important for both teams, if they want to win this game, to hit the free throw.
Wade missing. Smith had another chance. Timberlake. And it's good. What a move by Timberlake, throwing it up with the left hand.
Can't do much about that. The only thing there for Forcier is, if you're going to foul him, foul him. Don't just take a swat at him. It'll make it where he's not going to be able to put the ball in the hoop.
Set the numbers on the board for you. 12:03 remains regulation time. Boston University leading by 450-46. And Timberlake goes to the free throw line. Tonight he's perfect, 2-for-2. That's his first field goal of the game, but he was not brought to Boston University to score. He is their candid assist maker, and in high school he set a high school record at Boston College High School with 600 career assists. Good pass towards the 8 of Samley, and he is smoked.
And I'm sure they're going to call a two-shot intentional foul. They've got to.
Al Murray will come right over as Don Pajudi and his camera people pick it up.
And he did. The official signaled two shots out. Now, Gabriel did not mean anything nasty by that. That's a smart basketball move in terms of, you know, you don't want to let the uncontested layup. And he, you know, he could have just pushed him and shoved him, but he grabbed him where Shanley wouldn't fall down. I'm trying to figure out exactly what was called here. They must have called a flagrant intentional foul.
That's what it is. So it's like a technical foul.
Right.
It is a technical foul. Shanley misses.
Anytime it's flagrant. Now, there's a difference between intentional and flagrant. Anytime it's flagrant, that means intent. It's kind of like intent to harm, and then you get the two shots like a technical plus the ball back. I really didn't think Gabriel tried in any way to hurt them. I think he just wanted to stop Shanley.
I agree with you. He just kind of put a bear hug on him. So Marist retains possession underneath the basket. Al Murray checking something out here at the scorer's table. Allows us to tell you tonight's game being brought to you in part by Park Discount Beverages on Route 9, Hyde Park. At Park Discount, there's never a charge for cold beer.
So that's, you know, when it's deliberate and flagrant like that, you not only get the shots, but you get possession of the ball right back. So a nice break for Marist.
Smith fighting for position. Foul call. Joe Vigna to make it. 51-46 the score. Boston University holding on to a 5-point lead. They led by one at halftime.
I think Matt Forjanik in one of the last couple of timeouts must have said to both Carlton Wade and Drafton Davis, hey, get Rick the ball, because they're looking to him a lot more. They've got to keep getting him the ball.
Smith 3-for-4 at the line tonight. Came into the game 3-for-3. The sophomore
7'3", 240 pounds, and a poor time for Maris to go cold at the strike.
Yep, and that's, you know, it's something that it's so basic about the game, and it really, if you're a good free throw shooting team, it could mean 6, maybe 7 wins a year for it. It makes the difference. It's, you know, it looks so basic, but free throw shooting wins games.
Smith gets the second one. Gabriel taken out now, and Larry Jones, who had started the first 4 games of the year but did not start here tonight, is inserted into the lineup for the second time, played briefly in the first half. Maris, a 4-11 of 24 from the free throw line tonight.
Yeah, that's just pitiful, and it shouldn't be. They've got to do some work on that.
Our statistician, Mike O'Dowd, doing a good job for us, and there's another whistle.
Tim Beckwith's going to be whistled for that one. He did a nice job helping out there to double team, just a little over-aggressive. You know, this is going to be the type of game already. Maris with 5 key fouls this half, actually 6 now. Both will be in the bonus on the next foul. These 11 minutes are going to take a long time because every foul is going to be a shooting foul from now on.
Jones has a clean slate, and on the year he's 2-for-3 from the line. He is the sophomore, a transfer from CW Post, as he helped the Pioneers win the Big Apple title a couple years ago.
It might only be 5 team fouls on that. They haven't switched it, so there could be only 5 right now. Out there, it just went up to 6.
And Jones gets the second one. And again, Boston University holding on to a 5-point advantage. Beckwith teaming in the backcourt with Wade, and Davis is on the bench with 4 personal fouls. Beckwith hooking for Shamley. 11 minutes, 10 seconds remaining. Second half. Maris patient. Beckwith, good lead inside. And we have a charge on Beckwith as he knocked over Drayville, who was positioned directly in the lead.
Again, that's a young mistake. You have to realize when you're on the collegiate level that there are a lot of big guys in there who are not afraid to step in and pick up that charge. BU is not afraid to do that. Tim Beckwith has to realize that. Instead of going in for the layup, he's got to pull up for a jumper.
That was the 17 foul on Maris, but it was a player control foul, so they don't shoot. Ortega is all tied up.
Once again, it's important now for the officials to keep a close watch over things. They're doing a good job. They're calling all the fouls and close because the play is very physical. It's also important for the coaches to tell the players, hey, go in there and bang and don't give an inch. But at the same time, we don't want any fights. Because you get technicals start happening, you get players thrown out of the game, and you get away from basketball. And that definitely we want to avoid.
Boursier will toe the line for the first time tonight. On the year, he has not taken a free throw, so this is his first in the third game for Maris, and he does well. He missed 9 games last year with an injured ankle. He injured it in the 6th game, and in that game, he set a career high for himself, scoring 10 points against Delaware State. Krausevic is now in for Maris. He got in with just a second remaining in the first half.
And the fourth free throw shooting continues.
Grayville shoving Forcier at midcourt. The refs didn't see it. Timberlake takes just a bit too many steps.
Now, Matt Perjanic should right now get a technical because he's on the court.
I agree with you.
And he's got to be careful. The worst thing that can happen is get that C because it's a 2-shot foul plus you lose possession. And that is something you definitely do not want right now. Now, the refs have to be careful. Like I said earlier in the first half, this is the type of game that could erupt in a fight, and they have to be very careful.
Foul on Tony DeCosta. And both teams shoot the 1-1 from here on in.
That's just a little push and shove foul, but they're right there. They don't want anything to go from a push and shove to a real push and shove.
I think Joe Vigna and Al Murray realize that they've got a tense situation right here, and it started early in the ball game, and they want to keep a lid on it as much as they can.
They've got this hostile Poughkeepsie crowd and breathing down their necks. Nice crowd here, very lively crowd. That's one of the things that I like about the people that come to watch Maris basketball is they really get in and they give that home court advantage.
Not too many seats available as I looked around the McCann Center. 2,909 fans here. Wade 3-6 at the line, and he's got one more coming. Maris within 3.
Free throw is really just a matter of concentration. You know, with 10.5 minutes to go, every free throw is important. Of course, I'm sure this one's going to be decided on the free throw line.
Shamley hustling has it. Marist playing a bit of hot potato with the basketball.
You know, Shamley's not the most talented player, but he does a lot of those little things that really help a ball club win.
He's got that savvy, too, that junior savvy. Most experienced on the team, going across the sideline, stepping on the sideline is Vincent.
You know, I think that Carlton Wade and Tim Beckwith, Beckwith now is sitting down, have done a nice job filling in for Davis. In a pressure situation like this, you need your man drafting Davis, but of course he has four fouls.
Shamley trying to do it himself, and he does.
Now, Dean, there's the difference between Beckwith and Shamley's experience. Beckwith would go in that time he picked up the charge. Shamley saw the man there, stopped, halted, and hit a jumper.
Big knock calls Timberlake on the travel. 15 miscues for BU, 18 for Marist. Wholesale changes now made by both coaches, and we'll try and set it for you. For Marist out there, it's Wade, Forestier, Bougarel, and Shamley. Krasovic inbound.
By no means, as I say, you know, Beckwith was doing anything wrong, but that's the difference in experience in that type of thing. Is Shamley knew when to pull up and hit the jumper rather than go in and have a charge call on.
BU has DaCosta guarding Wade and a reach in on DaCosta. The other four for BU, Grayville, Timberlake, along with Irving and Ivy.
Marist, I think, Dean, is getting a little bit away from getting the ball inside. Now, Carlton Wade is doing a nice job. He's penetrating well. Beckwith did the same thing. But again, you've got to stay with your strength, and Marist cannot get away getting the ball inside. Obviously, with Rudy in there, it's not as easy. When Rick comes back in, I'm sure they'll try to go inside to him more.
Wade at the line tonight, 4 of 8. Came into this game shooting 83%, and he misses another key free throw. 52-51, the Terriers leading the Foxes. Under 10 minutes remaining in regulation time. Holiday Sports bringing you Marist College basketball. The block by Shanley, and he's in. He does the aerial.
Shanley's another player that goes with the flow of the crowd, plays in the streets. He's hot right now on both ends of the court. He's doing a fine job out there.
Crowd's a big. Looks pretty cool out there. The native of Budapest, Hungary. Shamley into the paint, he's called for step.
Matt Prochanek giggling at the call. An awful lot of little traveling violations. There's no doubt that, you know, you can call it on a lot of those times. Sometimes you might get a little carried away. Matt Prochanek thinks that he's been a bit of a stickler.
Matt, fix your tie.
You know, I asked him, I said he's got to start, you know, doing some fashion trends like Louis Kondasekin in a sweater, but he's too conservative.
That's what he says he is? Here's Timberlake, long range. And Timberlake with points 53 and 54 on the board for Boston. Shamley. And Bougarel over top. And Matt Prochanek saying to Marcus, let's slow it down and wait for your other teammates to get down there to get a rebound.
So of course, now, because both teams are over the limit, we're just going to walk down the other end. It's going to be a free throw shooting contest the rest of the way. I think Matt Prochanek would like to get it down to maybe 6-5 minutes and then put Drafton Davis back in. Obviously, you want Drafton in there at crunch time, but I think we'll see Drafton come back in with about 5 or 6 minutes. Hopefully, Marist can stay in there. Carlton Wade so far is doing a good job.
Before that free throw made by Ivy, it was Boston University hitting 16 of 21 from the line. Ivy is perfect tonight at the free throw line. 4 for 4. Tim Beckwith will come back in for Matt Prochanek's team. Out is Rudy Krasovic.
Marist crowd really getting into this game right now. Still plenty of time. 9 minutes is an eternity.
Marist trailing by 5. A lot of pressure on the defensive end. Wade had Forestier ahead, but decided to wait for the rest of the team to get down to the offensive end. Shamley, who's really been working the offensive end.
You know, he's doing right now, he's coming down the court. He's posturing himself and he's saying, I want the ball, and Shamley playing with confidence.
Shamley with 7 points, comes in averaging 13-5. The shot altered there by Bougarel.
Intimidation.
Here's Wade, looking to cut the lead to 1. Marist down by 3. Rhythmic applause from the crowd at the McCann Center. Shamley, pretty.
right now, Mark Shamley can do no wrong. You know, he sees this situation where Marist, of course, still has not found the man to take control down at the end, and he's doing it here tonight.
Shamley now with 9-4 via the field goal. And again, Timberlake quiets the crowd. Timberlake catching some fire the second half. 3 field goals, 3 free throws for a total of 9 points. 58-55, Boston University leading the hometown Red Foxes. Forestier, that's his positioning. Mike Jarvis, first-year coach of BU, says let's just slow it down.
Not a real good shot that time by Forestier. Not the fact that where it was, but really nobody was set inside. Everybody was moving around. Nobody had a chance to try for an offensive rebound.
I think he did have more room to move inside, too. He could have driven the lane.
Mastrojanic now back with that 2-3 zone. He's switching things back and forth to keep Boston on their toes.
Dedrick Irving bringing rain and connecting. Irving, who's been quiet in this game with a 22-point average coming in. And tonight, he has 5 field goals and 12 total points. Rudy, double team. Beckwith wisely pulls it out. 60-55, BU. That was a freshman play by Wade. Captain Davis is on the bench with 4 personal fouls, and you can see they are lacking his leadership. Remember, we've got that 45-second clock in college basketball this year, and neither team has really been affected by it. Boy, somebody came over the top and tapped it in as the crowd oozes eyes, and Matt Virginic says, let's take our second timeout of the night. So it's BU, again, out in front by 7, 62-55, 6:20 remaining here in the second half. We're back on College Sports after this.
The new fuel-injected Honda Civic CRX Si. Just how fast is it?
Friendly Honda, Route 44, Poughkeepsie. Availability has never been better.
Kind Construction does porches, windows, siding, roofing, skylights, additions, and conversions. Kind Construction, the reliable name in home improvement, has been taking the time to do it right the first time since 1969. Get guaranteed work from the responsible construction people with full 15-year financing available. Kind Construction. Call now, 462-2669, and start building your dreams.
I think one of the challenges of TV is to take your story, as complicated as it is, and break it down so everybody can understand it. And it's the challenge of, if I could say, marrying words with pictures. I think TV is a wonderful medium, and it really makes me feel good when I go home at night and I say, yes, I presented a story to my viewers that's interesting, that got something across that's of importance to them, and it's something that they can understand.
Local cable news. Our people make the difference.
Marist College has more than 3,000 students here at its own town of Poughkeepsie campus, including students studying in 24 undergraduate majors, 5 graduate programs. And Marist is a traditional liberal arts college with exciting features such as state-of-the-art computer technology and student internships. Marist College is committed to excellence in higher education, and it's right here in the Hudson Valley. Dwayne Vincent is allowed to be the airborne and knock it home. That was some tap.
He's only 6'2". He's a real fine leaper. Drafted Davis is now back in the game. I think that if Marist would have kept it to maybe a 3-point deficit, Drafted could have sat down a couple of more minutes. But because now it's 7, Mastrojanic says, hey, you know, it's do or die time. Let's get my man in there. So Davis has got the 4 fouls. And it's important, really, for Drafton not to play too cautiously, because then it's not his style of play. Even though he has the 4, he can't just, like, confine himself. He's got to go out and do it like he always does.
So Marist moving from right to left here in the second half. And Davis, as Mike mentioned, back in there, going with Smith, Wade, Shamley, and Beckwith. Man defense now by the Terriers. 6 minutes on the nose remaining. Tough shot for Smith. Shambling. Any foul.
I guess the phrase right place at the right time would go on that one. That's a bad shot by Rick Smith. He was still moving in the air when he turned around to do it. You know, again, we said it several times, and you don't want to beat a dead horse, but Smith has got to realize he's got to set himself and turn around and, as we keep saying, square himself before he puts it up. But Mark Shamley right now is really playing well out there.
Shamley struggling at the line, but he gets his second and 5 attempt. And Shamley on the night now with a total of 12 points, 9 in the second half. Gabriel, and he puts it into the face of Rick Smith and foul.
That's the problem. Matt Virjanik went to a man-to-man defense that time, and there's just no way that Rick can guard him man-to-man. Boston University did a good job. They cleared out the baseline. Rick went for the fake and gave up the baseline. You know, it's as big as Rick is, he just does not have the mobility to stay with these players man-to-man, and Rick had no business being out there trying to guard him from 20 feet.
Gabriel, 3 of 4 at the stripe tonight to go along with his 4 field goals. Tony has 11 on the night coming off the bench. So Gabriel with 12 points, and now Boston University again back to that 7-point lead, 65-58. 3-2 zone used by the Terriers. Terriers coming off a 15-15 year last year, 9-7 in the ECAC North. That was good enough for fifth place. And they all got all the way to the final game of the championship round and lost to Northeastern by 1. Carlton Wade from deep. Gabriel pushing for Timberlake. And McCarthy will be coming in on the next floor. And Matt Virjanik looking around. And again, the freshman mistake of taking too long a shot.
Well, right now, Marist, if you'll notice, Rick Smith, when the ball goes into the corner in the Carlton Wade or in the other corner, about 4 players surround Smith. The spot open is across diagonal. As you see a whistle off the ball.
Gabriel called on a hold on Smith. Bukarski. See who he's going to check in for. And Smith will go to the line.
That's the fifth foul on Gabriel. He's finished for the evening.
So Gabriel, who has played a major factor here in the game, is gone with 5. And he leaves the game with a total of 12 on the night.
He did a nice job, really held his own against Rick down there. Rick, of course, with a big height advantage, but Gabriel did a good job. He's a junior, so he's been around for a while. Again, here we go to that free throw line. Now we're down by 9 points. Of course, it's even more important. Marist really has to hit all their free throws from here on in, especially if they want to get back in the game.
Smith, 4 of 6 at the line tonight. Was perfect coming in, was 3 for 3. Smith, who has a string of 15 straight games in double figures coming into tonight's activity. And he continues that streak with a total of 13 points, make it 14. Karski checks in for Smith.
That's a good move by Matt Virjanik. Karski a little bit more mobile on defense, plus Rick needs a little bit of a breather. He's been in there quite a bit. Marist now, because they're down by 7, they're going to have to pretty much stick with the man-to-man the rest of the way and put a lot more pressure.
Vincent, bounce pass there for Timberlake. Timberlake, who was quiet in the first half, taking charge here in the second half. He had only 2 points in the first half. Now has 13 in the game. Grafton Davis pushing it up hard. Foul on the back for Karski.
That's not the shot that you want or need at this point. Mike Jarvis, a very smart move going to this 3-2 zone and putting the pressure. You know, it's very tough for a Carlton Wade and a Grafton Davis to get the ball over these 6-2, 6-3, and even 6-4 guards. And it's an excellent move to switch to this particular defense at this point.
Bukarski called for his 4th foul of the night. And it allows us to tell you tonight's game being brought to you by Kind Pools, located at Red Oaks Mills Road in Poughkeepsie. They have the largest selection of spas and pools in the Hudson Valley. Stop into the showroom for the best deal for the fall and winter. Ivy, 5 for 5 at the line tonight. Make it 6 of 6. Ivy, who did not start tonight's game, one of the tri-captains on the team, averaging just under 9 a contest, had 6 points against UConn the other night, shooting 2 of 7 from the field, 2 of 3 at the line. But here at the line tonight, he's a perfect 7-for-7.
That's been a big difference in this ball game. Marist down by 11. If they hit maybe half of their missed free throws, it's a different story.
The biggest lead of the night for the Terriers at 11, 71-60. We'll be back with you on Saturday night, 10 o'clock here on Channel 10, as Marist will be hosting Coppin State in the Pepsi Poughkeepsie Classic, and Marist turns it over for the 20th time. Good.
Again, they just have not gotten the ball inside at crunch time when they have to do it. You've got to go with your strength, and these live and die by the jump shot. That's saying it's true, and Marist really does not have the ability to hit the jump shot from long range.
But the University now putting it into high gear, and Maffigani takes another timeout. Boston University 73, Marist 60. We have 4 minutes and a second remaining. We'll be back after this.
When we close this box, we've done our best. You open this box, you enjoy the best. Hot, fresh pizza delivered to you in 30 minutes or less.
Domino's Pizza delivers.
Domino's Pizza delivers. Domino's Pizza delivers. Duchess AMC Jeep Renault. Duchess AMC Jeep Renault. Catch your Jeep at Duchess AMC Jeep Renault, 200 Church Street, Poughkeepsie.
If you want the taste of a full-bodied import on draft, try Genesee 12-4 Ale. It tastes imported, but it's America's own. Genesee 12-4 Ale.
Janik right now is telling his players, listen, we still have 4 minutes to go. 13 points is a lot, but it can't be done. Again, the 45-second clock is in your favor when you're down by this many at this point in the game. It's going to be tough. It's an uphill battle. Well, what Marist has to do, get the ball down court, get it inside, and score in a hurry. Now, on the other end, they've got to take chances on defense. Go for the steal. Not be afraid to put Boston University on the foul line. If you don't get the steal and you bump some guy, put him on the foul line, at least it stops the clock. So we're going to see Marist take a lot of chances, a lot of double teams, go for that steal, and Boston University is going to have to hit some free throws in order to clinch this one.
Boston University shooting 80% from the line tonight, 21 of 26, and that's the difference in the ball game.
Definitely, Dean. In terms of the actual percentage for Marist, I'm not sure of that right now, but it is not good at all. It's definitely below 50%. And when you have these one-on-one free throws that you miss, you know, that could be two instead of one. And, it wins, like I said earlier, six or seven ball games a year for you. And Matt Prochanek definitely has to do some more practicing on the free throw line with these guys.
Matt Prochanek, as you saw on the screen, with his assistant coach, Jim Todd. They've been together a couple years now. Jim Todd coming in from Columbia University. Smith exerting himself. Smith, who leads the team in field goal accuracy at 65% coming into this contest, hits one there. And he now is 16 on the night. 16th straight time he's been in double figures. Marist will have to play ball hawking defense. They trail by 11, and now the clock is against them. 18 seconds on a 45-second clock.
And that is not a bad foul at all. Crawford Wade has got to do something. Really, that time almost a minute went off the clock. What Marist really could start doing is if they don't make a steal on, say, the first, second, or even third pass, then you got a foul. But definitely not let time get off the clock. Hey, make Boston University win it from the foul line. Make them hit the free throws to win the game. It seems tedious, and it makes the game longer. But if you want a chance, that's what you have to do.
Vincent shooting 3-for-4 tonight at the 15-foot strike. Makes that one. He is a senior from Rockville Center. Last year averaged 7.6 a game. Came into this game averaging 16.5 a contest. Comes off a 18-point performance against Connecticut. And earlier this year had a career-high 22 points against George Mason.
Mike Jarvis with a smart timeout right here. He's going to settle things down for Boston University.
And tonight's game is being brought to you by Domino's Pizza with locations throughout the Hudson Valley, Route 52 in Fishkill, Route 9 in Wabash Falls, and Main Street in Poughkeepsie. Domino's Pizza delivers, and by Genesee Beer and Ale, the great outdoors in a glass. Dean Darling along with Mike Breen bringing you tonight's action. Red Al Marist trailing by 13. I think this is tough. What about Wednesday night when you go down to Jamaica, Queens, and take on the Redmen of St. John's? But again, a learning experience, and the lessons will pay off when it comes to January, February, and March.
Well, it's a phrase, learning experience, that perhaps people are going to get sick and tired of hearing, but it's true. You know, there's no doubt about it. This team is so young. There's nothing... nothing but potential here, and these games are all part of the building process that's going to make them into a good team. Matt Pajanic is a big believer of that. He'll sacrifice mistakes now. He'll sacrifice maybe a loss early in the season to get the team ready in the second part of the season in the conference schedule when it's most important.
One of our towel boys here wearing the new Marist sweatshirts, looking good. And some of the people now beginning to file out as they want to get a head start of the traffic. We remind you, and we would urge you to come on out and see this Red Fox team before it's too late, because we had 2,900 people here tonight and got a good opportunity to see the Pepsi Poughkeepsie Classic this coming Saturday and Sunday. They'll start it at 6 o'clock Saturday night with Marist hosting Coppin State.
And the pressure continues. Boston University not giving up, and that's a good coaching move. You don't just all of a sudden take off the press. You keep it in there.
Smith denied the base fly. 3 minutes. Wade with a launch. Bukarski climbing the back. Davis. Beckwith pushes. And finally, Ivy comes out of it and gets it off to Vincent.
Frustration now a little bit set again for the Red Foxes. One of those shots just not falling.
A lot of work, but no points. And now a foul call. Al Murray will make another call.
Well, a lot of casual fans will hear Cornell from the Ivy League, Boston University from the ECAC Northeastern section, and they'll say, oh, geez, Marist is losing to these teams. They're not the North Carolinas and stuff, yet they're losing. These are fine quality teams. That the ECAC Northeastern Conference is a tough conference. Cornell is an excellent team. They're very well coached. And, you know, again, when you have such young players, whereas Boston University had three seniors starting, it makes a great deal of difference. And there's going to be a lot of excitement here at Marist. You can see they have stretches of just super basketball. And pretty soon they're going to be able to put 40 minutes of basketball together and do it consistently.
Beckwith has fouled out. And at the line is Irving. Hit the first one, missed the second one. 76-62, Boston University. Davis trying to do it on his own. Vincent saving it on the end line. 2.5 remaining. Coast to coast. And it is Irving hitting.
What are you gonna do about that? You know, they went to get the foul, and he just puts it in. Frederick Irving, a fine basketball player.
Irving on the night, 6 field goals and 2 free throws for 14 points. In the first half, it was Irving scoring a total of but 4 points.
You know, Dean, it's like the Cornell game. Marist was in there the whole way, right down to late in the second half. But when it comes time for the pressure time, the crunch time, there's still not the leader who can go out there and take control and do it. Guys like Steve Egink and Teddy Taylor and Bruce Johnson who did it last year. And that's when the experience comes in. It's late in the game. It's in the pressure time. And pretty soon these guys will be able to handle it. But right now, it's not so easy.
Davis has taken 3 straight shots and missed them, but now Shamley with the garbage score. 79-64, Boston University. Shamley on the reach-around foul. At Boston University tonight at the line, 23 of 29. Shamley in his third personal.
Boston University's trio of Dwayne Vincent, the senior guard. Then you have Frederick Irving, the sophomore, and of course Tommy Ivey, another senior. Paul Hendricks, the senior. Now these guys, they've been through it before. A couple of them played in the NCAA tournament a few years ago. You know, Boston University only missed the NCAA tournament by a point last year. In their conference finals, they lost to Northeastern by 1 point. And, you know, they've been there. They've been in the situations. They play a tough schedule. Last year they played North Carolina and Iowa. This year on their schedule they've got the Oregon State and a couple other fine teams.
Vinson now the leader in scoring for both teams with 20. They get 21 coming off the 18-point performance against the University of Connecticut. He's never missed a game tonight, playing in his 95th straight here at the McCann Center. 81-64, 17-point advantage for BU. Shamley again.
Well, he's really unconscious tonight. Shamley can't do anything wrong. He's just played a super game. By this performance, you're definitely going to see him get a little bit more time. Matt Krajanek said that Shamley, really in the first part of the season, it's important for him to be out there because he's the one experienced and get that time until the others gain that experience.
You know, they've gone most of the second half without Hendricks, and he led the team in scoring against Marist last year with 17 points and 10 boards. BU doing well tonight here on the road. Shamley almost tipped it away. Irving going inside, dishing off. He was fouled there. Ivy fouled by Bougarel.
If you're wondering why Marist isn't committing the fouls now to set up for the free throw line, now when you have a 15-point difference, it's a little bit too much. But Marist did it with about 4 minutes to go. Matt Krajanek started the fouls. But Boston University just put it away from the free throw line. They were able to hit those one-on-ones and put the game out of reach. And you have to credit that. Good free throw shooting can do that. Once again, wins games for him.
Ivy at the line tonight, 7-for-7. Tonight's game is being brought to you in part by Dutchess AMC Jeep Renault, 200 Church Street, Poughkeepsie. We're the best deal dealer, the one to watch. Call 471-1020. He's now 8-for-8, and again, the free throw line has been the telling story in this game. Across the deck. Grayville kicks it back out. Minute 15 remaining, 82-66, Boston University. Marist will lose for the first time in six straight games at home. Carried over from last year. Irving didn't get much of a push up on the first shot, tied the second, then he got clipped.
Once again, that's the matter of going for that block shot. And if you don't block it, not only does the guy get the shot off and get past you, but you lose your rebounding position, and it gives up second shots. And Marist, though, of course, we're going to see a lot of block shots. You have to know when you can do it and when you have to just stay back and play some defense.
Boston University has turned a close game into a near romp as they led at halftime by 1 point, 36-35.
Little revenge factor this year for the Terriers.
After losing up there on their own home surface last year, as Marist went up there and played a good game, beat them by the count of 51-45.
Mike Jarvis does a real nice job with this team. You know, it's tough for players like Boston University. They've had the seniors on this team in their fourth.